In this video, let's discuss simplifying expressions with negatives. Okay, so recall that we have a second way of defining subtraction. We know that 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. But what we talked about in the video evaluating expressions with negatives is that this can also be viewed as 6 plus negative 2, which is equal to 4. So, as we mentioned in the previous video, evaluating expressions with negatives, sometimes this is useful. Now, we also discussed that you can also play the game of converting subtraction to addition and taking the opposite of what follows if you have a product. For example, if you have 7 minus 3 times, let's say, negative 2, what you can do is, well, do you see how it's a product here? In that case, you can take the subtraction and you can think of it as the negative belonging with a 3 and then do the multiplication. So we can think of this as negative 3 times negative 2, and that's positive 6. So that would be 7 plus 6, and that's equal to 13. Okay, so in this video, we're going to make use of both of those features again, or both of those techniques, I should say again, but now including variables. All right, let's go ahead and do this. So let's say that we wanted to simplify Okay, let's say that we had something kind of complicated, like 3 minus 1 half multiplied by 4x minus 6. Okay, so as you can imagine, this is a very important skill to learn in algebra, because expressions like this are very common, and they're going to aid us in solving equations. So where do we start? Well, we want to think about distribution. So there's nothing wrong if you think about distributing the 1 half, but what we can do is note that because it's multiplication, like we did above, up here, right? When it was multiplication, what we did up here is we thought of the negative as belonging with the 3. Same thing right here. When it's multiplication, I can think of the negative as belonging to the 1 half, and that's what I'm going to distribute, the entire negative 1 half. Now there's a second issue. Do you see how it's minus 6? I'm going to think of this negative as belonging with the 6. So I'm going to do two things. Think of that as belonging, this negative as belonging to the 1 half, and this negative as belonging to the 6. And then I'm going to perform my distribution. So the 3 is going to remain the same. Okay, and here's my thinking now. It's going to be negative 1 half times positive 4x. Well, a negative times a positive is a negative. And then what do I get? Well, once I've taken sine, I get 1 half times 4 over 1 times x. So do you see how I broke that into two steps? I first said a negative times a positive is a negative, and then I just wrote 1 half times 4 over 1 times x with the sine already taken care of. Okay, you ready to go on to the next part? Negative 1 half, again, times negative 6. Well, a negative times a negative is a positive. And what do I get after that? 1 half times 6 over 1. Okay, so I get a 3 minus, well, 2 goes into 4, it's going to be 1 time, or this becomes a 1 and this becomes a 2, so it's going to be minus 2x, and then plus, well, 2 goes into 6 3 times, so it's a 1 and a 3, so 2x plus 3, and then finally I combine like terms and I get, well, it's going to be 6 minus 2x. Okay, so it made it easy. This was easy when I thought of the negatives belonging to the 1 half and this negative is belonging to the 6. Okay, let's try another one like that. Okay, so let's simplify. All right, let's say that we had, how about 4x minus 2/3 times, how about negative 6x plus 2. So the same logic is going to apply. When it's multiplication, I can think of the subtraction that follows. I can think of the negative as belonging to, in this case, to the 2/3. So I'm not going to distribute 2/3. I'm going to distribute negative 2/3. Okay? So here we go. It's going to be, well, 4x remains the same. And then I think to myself, a negative 2/3 times a negative 6 is a positive, right? A negative times a negative is a positive. A positive what? Well, whatever I get when I multiply 2/3 by 6 over 1 times x. And then we go on to the next one. A negative 2/3, again, times a positive 2. Well, a negative times a positive is a negative. A negative what? Well, 2/3 times 2 over 1. So what do I get? Well, 4x plus 3 goes into 6 twice. And 2 times 2 is 4. Don't forget the x that's still there. And then minus, well, in this case, let's see, I have 2 times 2, which is 4 over 3. And now I combine like terms, and I get 4x plus 4x is 8x, and the negative 4/3 is still off to the side. And that would be my answer, because these are not like terms. We wouldn't be able to add these together. Okay, let's do one more to make sure we've got it. Let's go ahead and simplify. How about we take 5 minus 1/3 times, how about x plus 2. All right, so in this case, I see multiplication right there. And rather than distribute just the positive 1/3, we're going to think of this negative as going with the 1/3. So I'm going to distribute negative 1/3. The 5 remains the same. So it's 5, a negative 1/3. Now this is really a positive 1 attached to the x, right? So a negative 1/3 times a positive 1 is negative 1/3 x. You see that? Negative 1/3 times positive 1 is negative 1/3, and the x is still there. And now negative 1/3 times positive 2 is negative. So a negative times a positive is a negative, in this case 2/3. And now I can see that I have, well, 5 and negative 2/3. So let me write this as 5 minus 2/3 minus 1/3 x. And the way we add fractions is by getting a common denominator. So that common denominator will be 3, right? So I think of this 5 here as 5, I think of it as 5 over 1. So 5 over 1 minus 2/3 minus 1/3 x. And then I can get the common denominator of 3. So times 3 times 3. So I'm looking at, let's see, it's going to be 15 over 3 minus 2 over 3 minus 1/3 x. And let's see, 15 minus 2 is 13 over 3 minus 1/3 x. And that would be my answer. So what we saw in this video is that it's very helpful to think of a negative as belonging with what you're going to distribute. As we saw even in this previous example right here, it looks fairly complicated, but it's not so bad if you imagine this as belonging to what follows and distributing the entire that entire, in this case, negative 2/3. Okay, so we'll be using this when we solve equations. Stay tuned.